Thomas the Tank Engine and Friends, Wooden Railway Adventures, Episode 177, Bulgy Takes the High Road. Sir Topham Hatt's engines were waiting patiently at Natford Station one morning. The clock was about to strike 8 and the platform was deserted. "Where is everyone?" asked Thomas. "All of our passengers are running late."
"They're not running late," grumbled Gordon. "Our passengers aren't showing up at all today, and probably not for the next few days."
Toby looked glumly at the clock.
"It's time for us to leave," he said sadly, "and we have no passengers."
"Oh, look, here's some," cried Thomas happily.
"I don't care if the passengers don't show up," grunted James. "They're always complaining about everything, it seems like."
The passengers overheard what James said and immediately walked away.
"Well done, James," said Gordon. "You scared away what little chance we had of pulling our trains today."
"This is appalling," agreed Thomas. "Annie and Clarabelle aren't even half full."
"This reminds me of my old railway right before the end," said Toby sadly. "There were fewer and fewer passengers until one day there were none."
Just then, Sir Topham Hatt walked up. He looked quite sad, too.
"Hello, everyone," he said quietly. "If you couldn't tell it already, the railway inspector has finally released his review. It's all over the island by now, and I'm sure the passengers have seen it."
"Where have they all gone?" asked Toby.
"Well, they won't be riding in trains for a while," said Sir Topham Hatt. "The inspector wasn't kind about what he thought of our railway, to say the least. Fortunately, I think Bertie and Bulgy will be able to handle the load today. I'm positive that over the next few days, the passengers will realize what a wonderful railway this is, and they'll gradually start choosing rails over roads again."
The engines weren't happy still.
"I can't imagine how busy those buses are," wondered Gordon. And indeed they were busy. Bulgy and Bertie hadn't seen crowds like this in years. While Bertie was pleased at the attention he was getting, Bulgy was cross at the amount of traffic.
"Stupid nonsense," he grumbled. "Come on, come on, all of you. I'm going to break down with all of this weight I'm carrying."
And he was grumpy for the rest of the day. The next morning, the passengers were still ignoring the platform and instead flocking to the buses stationed outside. It was Henry's turn to pull the express, and he was shocked.
"Gordon wasn't lying," he murmured. "I'll only need one express coach today."
"I might as well leave Clarabelle," said Thomas sadly. "There's no point in me carrying around an empty coach."
"Care for a race, Thomas?" chuckled Bertie. "You're guaranteed to win, as I'll be stopping at every station while you can go right on through with your empty coaches."
Thomas pretended he hadn't heard. Just then, the railway inspector walked over next to the buses. He had a very sly look on his face.
"Yes, I was the one who wrote that review," he said loudly. "No need to thank me."
The passengers completely ignored him as they waited in line.
"Oh, no worries," he said confidently. "They'll recognize me sooner or later."
The engines looked on at the busy scene.
"It's ridiculous," complained James. "We deserve to take those passengers, not cheeky Bertie and grumpy Bulgy."
Toby laughed. "What happened to yesterday's motto of who cares about the passengers?"
"I was wrong. I was very wrong," said James. "I'd rather have grumbling passengers than no passengers at all."
The railway inspector noticed the banner on the side of Bulgy.
"Ah, the Anti-Rail League," he asked curiously. "What's this all about?"
"It's nothing," grunted Bulgy. "Something I tried a few years ago that didn't work out."
The railway inspector was fascinated with the idea.
"The Anti-Rail League," he repeated. "That's what I've been saying this whole time. You are a very smart bus."
Bulgy was flattered. He had never been praised so kindly before.
"I want to see what this Anti-Rail League thing is all about. Would you mind taking me around the island?"
Bulgy nearly popped a gasket.
"Absolutely, sir," he shouted. "Come with me. Join the Anti-Rail League."
The railway inspector hopped aboard and took up the front two rows, forcing some of the passengers to stay behind at the station.
"Now's our chance," said Thomas. "Over here, over here. Come take a ride in our wonderful coaches."
Things were beginning to look up for the engines. Later that day, when Bulgy arrived at Ellsbridge Station, the railway inspector immediately hopped out. The platform there was deserted, too.
"I'll be right back," he said quickly and darted inside.
Bulgy became curious. He rarely saw anybody use that door nowadays.
"Doesn't that lead to Sir Topham Hatt's office?" he wondered.
"What's that?" asked Sir Topham Hatt himself as he rounded the corner.
"Oh, nothing," grunted Bulgy. "Nothing, sir."
"All right, then. You've done a very excellent job of keeping up with the extra demand. Maybe it's time you received a new coat of paint. And while we're at it, we should remove those old banners. I can't believe I've overlooked those all these years."
Sir Topham Hatt walked away just as the railway inspector exited the station.
"Let's go," he said quickly. "Take me to Suttery right away."
Bulgy was surprised at the quick pace, but didn't question it. Back at the yard, the Diesels had arrived and were very cross. Sir Topham Hatt was trying to calm the situation.
"What seems to be the problem here?" he asked loudly.
"The railway inspector is leaving today," grunted Airy.
"He promised us a new diesel works," shouted Bert.
"And we should hold him to it," agreed Den.
Sir Topham Hatt sighed. "The railway inspector is supposed to leave out of the airport later today," he said.
"But you're right. I won't let him leave this island until he fulfills his promise."
The Diesels weren't convinced, but realized that Sir Topham Hatt was doing his best. Back at Suttery, the railway inspector had jumped inside the station, and Bulgy was waiting for him. Just then, Ryan puffed up.
"Oh, hello, Bulgy," he said.
"Wait, what's the inspector doing up there? That's Sir Topham Hatt's office. He's not supposed to be in there."
The railway inspector leaped over the balcony and climbed into Bulgy.
"Onward," he cried.
Bulgy quickly sped away, and Ryan chased after him. Back at Knapford, the Diesels were growing more impatient.
"Where's the railway inspector?" asked Norman.
"I can't find him," said Sir Topham Hatt. "I don't know where he's gone."
"Look out!" cried Thomas. "Here comes Bulgy, and he's flying!"
Bulgy raced around the bend and climbed the Knapford Viaduct. He lost control and promptly tumbled off the edge to the track below.
"The passengers!" cried Percy.
A moment later, the railway inspector climbed out of one of the windows, rubbing his head. He was the only one aboard.
"You miserable bus!" he shouted. "You're no better than these terrible engines. Your anti-rail league slogans are, well, they're disgraceful, disgusting, and..."
"Despicable?" asked Henry.
"Yes, that too!" shouted the inspector.
Bulgy was very cross.
"You told me to drive fast. I was only doing what you were saying."
Just then, Ryan puffed in. He was glad that the railway inspector had been stopped.
"Mr. Inspector," boomed Sir Topham Hatt, "before you leave, you need to keep your promise and update the diesel works. I have a bunch of angry Diesels here who will not take no for an answer."
The railway inspector laughed.
"I've already released my review. My work here is done. Goodbye, Topham, and the rest of you. Now where's my private engine? I'm going to miss my flight."
"That's it," said Sir Topham Hatt. "If you're done here, then we are done with you. Enjoy that nice long walk to the airport, as I'm certain no engine of mine will be taking you there."
The Diesels and steam engines nodded in unison. No one would be taking the railway inspector anywhere.
"Very well, then. Good day."
And he scuttled away to the airport.
"Good riddance," shouted Thomas. "About time that horrible man left."
And the rest of the engines whistled loudly as the terrible railway inspector finally disappeared from sight.